What is up, y'all? T-Dub here of the Resoul 206 coming at you with another tutorial. Today, we are rocking with some super clean, brand spanking new, all-white Adidas Superstars. That perfect buttery leather. There's no better canvas than a brand new shoe. We're about to freak these. These are going to be a 100% custom, meaning the entire shoe will be covered in paint once it's all said and done. So let's get started. All right, so first things first, I want to make sure to prep our canvas properly. Preparation is absolutely key when it comes to customizing a sneaker. Now, when you buy these shoes out of the store, there will usually be a factory finish on the leather that, of course, protects it and, you know, prevents any sort of staining and things of that nature. We want to go ahead and remove that to give ourselves a nice canvas to lay our paint onto. And sanding is a great way to do that. A lot of these leather, you know, uppers and things are gonna be really, really smooth. They're gonna have a nice buttery texture, which actually doesn't help when it comes to having paint stay attached to a shoe. Now, when you make it in the factory, it's one thing, but what we do as customizers is something totally different. It's an addition, and that requires, again, a good amount of preparation. So what we're doing here is we're sanding down every part of the shoe that is going to receive paint. We want to make sure that we have a nice tooth to our canvas so that the paint adheres properly and stays put so that people can wear the shoes and not have to worry about them cracking or peeling or their art falling off like moments after they get them. So again, preparation is key. One other step that I did not get a chance to film in this process is preparing and deglazing the canvas as well. And what that looks like is taking, you know, rubbing alcohol, things of that nature, acetone, cotton balls, and removing that factory finish, you know, with a solvent like that. I'm gonna give them a quick brush off, get any sort of debris, and we got ourselves a nice clean canvas. Boom, baby. All right, so what you're looking at now is the design that myself and the customer agreed upon. So we kind of went, did our back and forth brainstorming certain ideas. Of course, we are going with the Seattle Kraken motif. I went on the internet, good old Google, and found color codes as well as some logo designs that our customer Strawberry wanted on his shoes. He wanted to keep it, you know, pretty casual, but also have a nice little flash. So we went ahead and did that for him, designed it up nice and good. Next thing we're gonna do with the logos is actually put them into our Cricut design space so that we can create some vinyl stencils to apply them to the shoe. Cricut is, man, such a godsend. I remember the days, you know, I've been doing this for a very long time when I would have to cut stencils by hand and my fingers would be cramping and it was just incredibly time consuming and very painful. Now we have a whole system that does it for you and saves us so much time and so much money and so much frustration. Now, one thing I will say is doing multicolored stencils is not easy. You have to do an individual stencil for each color. So for example, with this Kraken S, it's actually made up of four colors. So I had to do four stencils just for that one piece of logo. So it can take a good amount of time. Make sure that you're, you know, staying patient. This process is not easy. Again, you know, I ended up having to do a good amount of resizing and refining and cleaning up of the actual logos because they were ripped from the internet. You know, you can't get a nice clean vectored image all the time from Google. So you kind of have to do a lot of DIY with stuff like that, making sure that it's sized properly and making sure that the lines are nice and clean, because whatever you put in your Cricut design space, that is what it will print out. And you're about to see what I'm talking about in just a moment. So what I'm doing here is applying my vinyl sticker to my cutting mat. I use a nice little scraper here to make sure it's nice and flush, no bubbles, no bumps in the road. And then we are gonna go ahead and feed that into our Cricut machine, Cricut cutting machine. And press cut. And the machine literally does all the work for you. As you can see, I am very pumped. Anytime I get to use this thing and save myself some time is very, very helpful. And yeah, it just, whatever you put in there is what it creates. And I'm gonna talk about that in a little bit more in a second. Now, as you can see here, the Seattle Kraken logo looks pretty good. The anchor is looking really nice, but those S's are jacked up. I was so in shock at how bad these came out. But again, this is what happens when you rip images from the internet. You have to take them into whatever programs you use, whether it be Photoshop or what I'm using nowadays, which is a super godsend, is Adobe Fresco, which actually vectors images straight into the program. You have to, you know, you have to resize and reproduce and redo a lot of stuff that you rip from the internet through these avenues so that your stencils and things like that actually come out with nice, clean, crispy lines and not all this jagged gnarliness that I had had to deal with. I ended up having to actually do a few passes of the S to get it to where it needed to be. But this is what comes with the territory, you guys. You know, you see all these videos on the internet, 60-second clips from, you know, nothing to magic. There's a lot that goes into that, and that's why I felt important, you know, to go ahead and show you guys a little bit of my process. Even after 20 years in the game, there's still a lot of learning that takes place. So what we're doing here is we're actually weeding out the different colors of our logo design. So you see here I have two Kraken logos. This is actually one logo separated into its two colors. So when I actually do apply this to the shoe, I have to do each color with its own stencil. So it's a bit of a process, but you know, it makes it look super crispy and super clean when it's all said and done. A lot of people don't like the weeding process, but I actually don't mind. I think it's pretty cute. All right, and so as you can see, we have a nice prepped canvas here. I went ahead and taped my shoe off. All the areas on the shoe that will not be receiving paint are all completely taped off. And we are now sort of just placing and you know, making sure that our logos and stencils are proportioned to the area where the design will sit. So we want to make sure that the logo is not too big, it's not too small, and it's centered and it's proportional to the shoe, and it's going to look make for you know, a nice clean finished product. Very important to make sure that detailed images like this have a nice flat surface to sit on. I would never put something like this over the stripes, for example, because that would just be ridiculous. You know, having to navigate all of those different levels, you know, it would just be too much. So make sure you have a nice clean surface for your detailed logo designs. Looks like I had to reprint something here. Might have been a little too big or too small, so we went ahead and, you know, made more. Preparation, again, is so key to what we do. Like, if you spend most of your time preparing, I say that's for the best, because you're more often than not going to come up with a better finished product. You know, so make sure that you, you know, take your preparation seriously. And as you can see, there are just entirely too many pieces that I've had to sort of trial and error here. Taking them through the Cricut, making sure everything is nice and clean. You know, see that? Much, much better. Nice, clean, regular lines, not all jagged and crazy. That's what we want. That's the desired outcome. You see that one's still pretty jagged, so I probably went ahead and redid that one just to make sure that we don't have any issues when it comes time to lay down our paint. All right, and I, of course, did not film this either, but this is the first layers of our base coat on our kicks. Got this nice powdery blue happening here. I, for whatever reason, I just love a sort of like profile difference. So I went ahead and went with the dark blue on the outside of the shoe and the light blue on the inside and reversed that with the stripes. I think it looks really cool. The Kraken colorway is actually really, really fun and like a great colorway. I love that little pop of red in the eye that they have. So yeah, these are a really fun project. And the great thing about base layers, what I'll talk about now, base coats, as you can see, not coming off. Preparation is key. That's how you know it's real. Great thing about base layers is it is, for me, is an opportunity to sort of get out of my head about perfection. The key to a great base coat of paint is what you see here, is that sort of imperfection. You want to make sure that you do a nice thin layer of your first coats of paint, because the thinner the layers, the better the adhesion. So those first layers are key when you're trying to get nice, clean, smooth coverage, you know, when you're painting a shoe like this. All right, next day, we are finally airbrushing, about to get ready to do our logo work. So what you see here is our nice thinned out paint colors. What we do is we take our Angelus paint and we add a little fabric medium to it, which obviously thins out the sort of thicker paints, thicker leather paints, and thins them out so that they can actually flow nicely through an airbrush gun. And we got our first sort of color here on the S, looking pretty nice. All the areas again that are not getting painted are getting covered so that we don't have any, you know, overflow, anything getting where it's not supposed to be. Yep, there's my little strainer situation there. I want to make sure that we get any sort of, you know, anything that'll clog up your gun, you want to make sure that you get that out as soon as possible, because you will spend a lot of time trying to, you know, fix that after the fact. Yeah, check out that. So that's a couple coats of that base layer on there. You know, we hand paint the first couple layers and then we'll airbrush the rest to make sure that the finish is nice and clean and smooth. Everything's looking real lovely. And there you have it, folks, the final product. Giving that nice little crepe protection on there, nice little water stain repellent, so we don't gotta worry about no spills, no situations on our fresh, clean kicks. Some of the things I didn't get to document were the strawberry that's on there. I went ahead and removed the superstar off of the shoe and added strawberry's name to just give it that extra personalized, customized touch. Don't nobody got these kicks but this dude, you know, and he's repping the Kraken in a real way.
I'm excited too. T, are you kidding me?
I'm so pumped. Got some custom shirts. Let's see what we're looking at.
Ooh, these are nice.
Yes, sir.
Oh, shoot.
Ah.
Oh, shoot.
Check those out.
These are nicer than the photos you sent me.
Appreciate it, man.
I like this.
Yeah. The nice little perforated, yeah, kind of matching the jersey motif. See all the Kraken on there? You see it? You see it?
The name on the side too?
Custom.
And the logo?
One of one. That's how
these
we do.
These are fire.
Yes, sir.
These are fire.
Glad you like them, man.
Dude, I love these. Good job.
And I got
and
you
get the tongue too. The tongue, wasn't.
Yeah.
Because these were all white.
Yep.
Sheesh.
Full coverage, baby.
These are
ready
nice.
Ready for the ice. Ready for the ice.
Nice. They are ready for the ice.
Yeah, man. And there you have it, folks, another custom in the books for T-Dub. I want to thank y'all for watching. Man, the Resole 206 is coming, Seattle. Let's get it. We are about to open our doors sooner than you know. Make sure that you go ahead and support this cause by donating to givebutter.com/resole206. We are trying to raise funds to open our doors. We are so excited to bring you Seattle's very first dry cleaner for sneakers, where we will be offering cleaning, restoring, and customizing services in a state-of-the-art facility right in the heart of the Central District. We really need our city to be a part of this. I'm so excited to bring it to you guys. We got more to come, more customs to come, more cleanings to come. Make sure you stay tapped in the Resole 206, and we'll see you on the next one. Peace.